This is an installation and setup guide for Visual Studio Code for the Mac operating system. In this tutorial, in addition to taking you through the installation process, I will also give you a few tips and guides on how to get started working with Visual Studio Code. The installation process on macOS is a straightforward process. Type in Visual Studio Code. Okay, so I've typed in Visual Studio Code into Windows, and you can see that we're going to be navigating to code.visualstudio.com. Now, you can click on the download option here if it's available. If not, don't worry. So this takes me to this page right here. So you can see that there are lots of different versions of Visual Studio Code for multiple operating systems. So let's go ahead and download this for Mac OS. So I'm going to click on the Mac option here. That should start downloading. It is quite a large program, so depending on your internet speed, it might take a couple of seconds. But once Visual Studio Code has downloaded, what you're going to find is it will start from the download. So you can see that we've downloaded an app essentially here, .app. So if I double click on that, you can see that Visual Studio Code will open. So that's not necessarily something we want to have set up on our computer, that we have to go to the download folder and actually start the application in that way. So let's just go through the process of placing this application in the application folder. So I'm going to close Visual Studio Code. Now, apologies, you can't see this, but up top here, just make sure you're on the desktop. I'm going to select Go from the list, and then I'm going to select Applications here. So what we want to do is we want to take our download and we want to place it within this folder here. So what we need to do here, just navigate over to Downloads if it's available. I'm going to just drag that across to Applications. Now, I already have that in my folder, so I'm asked if I want to replace it. So go ahead, and if there is an option, we want to obviously copy that across to the folder. Okay, so once that's copied across, if I go to Applications, go down to the bottom here, you can see that we have Visual Studio Code now inside the Applications folder. So what we can also do now is just drag this onto our bar at the bottom here. So again, you can't see that, but I'm just going to drag that down onto the bar so we have that available. So now we can go ahead and, although you can't see this, in my bar at the bottom here, I'm just going to select Visual Studio Code, and that will then open up Visual Studio Code. In order to work with Visual Studio Code, what we need ideally is a project folder. So we work from a project folder. So let's go ahead and make a new folder on my desktop here. I'm just going to call this code. I'm just going to call this folder. Let's call it project, actually. So I'm going to call the folder project. It looks like I already have a folder called project. So let's call this project one. Okay, so this is my project folder. All the code associated to the program that I'm developing will be inside of this folder. Here in Visual Studio Code, the first step upon opening Visual Studio Code typically is that we open the folder that we want to work within, the project that we want to work with. So we have a few options here on the left-hand side, but typically in the middle with the Get Starting tab here, we have the Open. So I'll go ahead and select Open, go to Desktop, go to Project 1, and press Open. So that's the project folder here on the left-hand side. You can see we've got a few different tabs here, Search, the top one being Explorer. So we can have all the files open related to our project as we develop. And in addition to that, we can go ahead and create files. So let's just create a new file, example.py. So Python files have the extension .py. So here's a Python file. Now what you'll find is that the new folder we created earlier now has the file we just created. So you can see how that relates now to our project. So if you have lost this Explorer, remember it's a tab here that we can select. So just make sure that you've selected the Explorer tab. Now, you notice that we are using tabs. So we can go ahead and close tabs if we want to, and then we can open these files. These files will open in tabs up the top here. Now, what we can also do is split this screen. So maybe later on, you want to work with two files. So you can go ahead and utilize this option here to split the screen even further. That can be a handy tool to have when you're working with two files. Now, one of the most common mistakes I find that new developers fall into is they forget to save their file when they run their code and therefore receive certain errors. So in Visual Studio Code, notice that when we don't save a file, let me just turn off autosave. If we don't save a file, you can see the dot appears here indicating the fact we haven't saved a file up the top here. So that can be very frustrating and you can forget that. So if you go to File and then select Autosave, everything just gets autosaved. So that's an option that you want to turn on. Something else no doubt you'll want to do is zoom in and zoom out using the mouse key. If you're using a mouse or whether you're using the touchpad. So you can press Command and use a touchpad to kind of two buttons up and down that will scroll in and out. Now to enable that, you'll need to go to Code, Preferences and Settings. Okay, Code, Preferences and Settings. So you saw that mine was grayed out because I needed to select the window again, just somewhere in the middle. So Settings, and then from here, I'm going to use the search bar here to select, I think it was Scroll. Scroll, maybe not. Let me just double check here. Zoom. I think I need, there we go, Zoom. So I select Zoom or type in Zoom and select the mouse wheel Zoom. So that is off by default. So you need to turn that on in order for you to easily zoom in and out of your code. Alternatively, you can press Command and plus and minus, and you can see the whole screen, the whole interface will scale. So that's another way that you can scale the screen, the interface. So last of all, you'll want to utilize the terminal, or we're going to be utilizing the terminal quite often. Now, if I drag from the bottom here, you might not be able to see this, but just at the bottom here, you can see my mouse at the bottom of the screen there. You can drag up, there's a line, it can be dragged up, an up arrow appears, and I can drag up the terminal and drag it back down. So here I can access the terminal directly in Visual Studio Code, so I can type in Python 3--version. That we learned in the previous tutorial. That shows me the version of Python that we're using. Now there's a number of different ways to access this terminal. If you select View from the top menu, just select the window over here again. So just double click on the screen here, go to View, and you can see here that we're given the option here, or there's a shortcut key combination here that we can utilize to access the terminal. So that's Command and it's the key just above on your Mac keyboard. So that will open and close your terminal. So that's a more convenient way of opening and closing our terminal. If you do experience any installation errors when installing Visual Studio Code, then do check out Stack Overflow. It's likely that someone else has had the same problem. So it's likely that there will be a solution for you.